Hello, this is a spiritual crystal card reading for Capricorn for the month of May. So let's see what is your main energy for the month for Capricorn. So, main energy for Capricorn. Here you are. So there are two. That means, first of all, you have turquoise. Turquoise, that is a stone that is telling you for slowly, slowly you will get a whole picture out of the situation. That means many things may have happened the last months and they start to make this one picture. Second, you have silver. So when I see this, I would say this month for you is something that, because of the silver, it says get in touch with your creativity. So your creativity is very important for you this month. So that means the creativity, it's the right side of the brain. That means you're also your intuition. That means the female side of your person. So get in touch with this, see what is going on there, because you have the turquoise that gives you the possibility to put everything nice in a row so that you start to understand more about what happened in the past. But also because of the silver, I would say, see what is going on there, because maybe you want to change something out of this picture, you know, maybe there is something that is not really in place there. Maybe you are thinking and you put the whole story together and you say, yes, but this in there is not really what, it's not going together. This thing is not really fixing in there. So maybe think about this, because maybe it is something that you have to let go for to be the whole, to have the whole picture, for to find this wholeness, this harmony. Maybe there is something that needs to go or to leave, for to find your harmony. So let's see. Let's go for 1 week to the other. So the first week, a little bit more information about the first week. First week, that means that goes on. So you have the main energy that we said. Find out, meditate about this. Meditate about this. What is it actually that is something that is not fitting in the whole picture? Meditate. First week. Second week is you keep on going on meditating, because here you have again two cards. You have Jade and Snowflake Obsidian. What it actually means is that you keep on meditating on your anger. I think there is something that is producing anger in you. So look at this. What is the anger? Why is the anger there? What is the trigger of the anger? Maybe it gives you the opportunity to learn something more about yourself. Maybe it gives you the opportunity to see how you can handle this better. So let's see for the third week. Let's go to the third week. Third week of May. And this is here, this is Falcon Eye. So Falcon Eye is telling you, make the problem smaller, because maybe you have been blowing it up, and through this meditation maybe it becomes very big, and you, it's difficult for to let it go or to move away from it. So if this is the case on the third week, meditate and do this meditation that you are actually that you are the falcon. And you fly higher and higher, and you start to see all the things becoming smaller and smaller. And in the beginning you can put this house, a house where all the problem is, all the anger is in this house. And it's full, you're in this house, it's full of anger. And then you start to meditate, you go on, and you be this falcon, and slowly, slowly you start to get higher, you start to elevate, let's put, out of this house, and you start to see the house becoming smaller and smaller, with all the attention and knowledge that in this house is your anger, or is the theme of the anger, what is producing the anger. And let it become smaller and smaller and smaller, and then of course the anger can be healed by love. So at that moment, when you have the anger becoming so small, then you just start to fill it with love, this house. And the anger, you let the anger disappear. You start to feel maybe somebody left you, and you are very angry about this. You are very angry. So you start to fill this house with love, because you have a distance on it. You are not confront, you are not midden in the emotion. You are through doing the falcon. You are seeing, or the eagle, as you like. You are seeing your problem becoming smaller and smaller, so you get detached from your emotion. And through this detachment, you can allow the universal love, the unconditioned love, to stream through you, and allow this love to go to the house where the anger is, or where the person is, or where the situation is that is producing this anger. Because that's actually how you can cure, how you can get rid of your anger, but also how you can actually transform the whole situation of anger between you and the other person, or the situation that is producing the anger can be transformed if it is in harmony with the love. So that's for the third week. Third week, Falcon Eye. Fourth week. Fourth week is of May. Fourth week for you. It falls on its own. And again, too. It's very nice. So here you are. Here you are. This is Sapphire and Smaragd, Emerald. Well, I've actually two very beautiful stones, very beautiful crystals. So here you have this Emerald. Emerald is the guiding of the heart, is the wisdom of the heart. And then you have Sapphire, is the wisdom of the third eye, the wisdom of the thoughts. So actually you have this, put the wisdom of the heart with the wisdom of the third eye. So your thoughts and your heart is actually what we have been saying here before, you know. So if you do this meditation, if you work on it, you will actually become on the fourth week this peacefulness in the heart, this wisdom, and the wisdom of the thoughts. So the anger or whatever emotion is disturbing you and bringing you on a lower plane of energy will be cured, will be healed, will be gone, and you will be more on a higher. So that's where then the tourmaline, not the tourmaline, the turquoise is coming. The turquoise would say the whole picture. So put out this, it's like a thorn, you know, a thorn, yeah, this wood, stick a little splinter in your finger. That's like how, what's happening here. So pull out the splinter and let the wound heal so you can use your full head. So anyway, that's what it's all about here. Let's see what is the message of the angels. What do the angels have to say to you? But please do this, because it's going to be very, you have really a nice opportunity here for to get rid of something that you don't need. So let's see, what is the message of the angels for you? For Capricorn, rose quartz, the healing of the heart. So rose quartz is also when it's already half healed. Let's say that you are already in the healing process. So what I would suggest for to support through all this thing here, and because it's the message of the angels, I would say put the rose quartz in 1 liter of water, in 1 liter of water, and drink it during the day. In the night you fill up your bottle again with water, and you can even write under the bottle, you can write on a little paper, love and peace, forgiveness, whatever emotion is there that is disturbing you, for to move on, you can write it under the bottle. So love, forgiveness, peace, you know. And don't write, of course, anger under the bottle. Because then you're gonna drink rose quartz and you're gonna like this, you're gonna have all this anger coming. You don't program your water with anger. You program your water with the words of love, peace, and forgiveness, for example. If now you have difficulty of finding why are you angry, what is actually, how can you deal with it, you can meditate with the snowflake obsidian, but be careful, because snowflake obsidian, let it come to the surface. So do this if you have already worked with your anger, or if you know how to deal with your emotions. Don't do it if you have never worked with this before. Then I would say meditate with jade. If you have any experiences, then you meditate with snowflake obsidian, because it will help you to go to let it come up, and so that you can deal with it faster. So I think that's all for May. I think it's a very interesting month, and if you work with it, you really have nice possibilities here because of the emerald and the sapphire. It's very beautiful. So drink rose quartz or wear rose quartz, for this will cool down also a little bit the heat of the anger. And you can also, if you like, you know, you can also wear an smaragd, emerald. You can also wear an emerald, because emerald is very, very peaceful, not peaceful, but very, has a deep wisdom in the heart. So you can wear this emerald. It will support you to deal with all this with an inner wisdom of the heart. So I think that's it. If there are any questions, you can of course contact me through my website or my email, and when I have time I will answer. And if you would like a personal spiritual crystal card reading, you can also contact me and we will make an appointment. Thank you for watching and enjoy this month.